fighter. You should just charge out, try to overwhelm his opponents. Now works behind the jab, and coming right at Brockman is Steve Pinnell.
Yeah, he's a lot to prove. He has heard the critics. Steve Pinnell has a lot to show in this fight. He says, I can box, but I can also sit down on my punches, and I use angles in the ring. Not much angle about that. He angled right toward Haseem Rahman, showing that he's not afraid of Rahman.
You know, you talked about the three times Pinnell has stepped up and lost and knocked out. He's actually knocked down 8 times in those 3 fights against Ernest Mateen, Denmark's unbeaten Michael Lindblad, and also against John Ruiz. That was his last loss back in October of 95. But today, Pinnell explaining that, says that in those 3 losses, he's a tweener. He was too big then to be a cruiserweight, not big enough to be a legitimate heavyweight, and was kind of caught in the middle and really had to let nature take its course and grow into the heavyweight body, which he has done now at 222. He was stuck around 200 pounds. He kind of feels that that may have been a contributing factor, and that now he is ready. So 16 in a row. And talked about the Tennessee twosome of Ken Bowman, who knocked off Murphy Sosa. Antoine Echols knocked off Brian Barbosa, zoomed to number 2 in the world in the middleweight division. And now trying to turn that Tennessee twosome now into the Tennessee trio. Guys coming out and backing up their big records. Pinnell 33-3 coming into this fight, and he comes in under the tutelage now of Greg Page, former heavyweight champion of the world, a master technician, and teaching Pinnell the angles, how to take Rock's power away from him, how to move and get out of the way of the power of Rahman that has unleashed 22 knockouts in his 27 fights.
Oh, good right hand from Pinnell. Pinnell coming from the Midwest, and also I came from the Midwest, and I tell you, to get the critics off your back, you have to get in and perform. The only times he's moved up in class, good left hook from Rahman, he has failed. And the critics look at that and they say, well, he's a Midwest fighter, he can't perform in the big time.
Well, he's certainly taking the major step here tonight, yeah, and stepping in and looking to trade with Rahman.
Definitely is, but he feels like he is up for the task. He's been sparring with Oliver McCall. Good right hand, both fights. Oh, Pinnell is hurt. Down.
You cannot be saved by the bell, which should not be a situation here. The count is on. Just got to survive to the bell several seconds. May not even have to take another punch. And Rahman will wait it out into the corner. So Steve Pinnell, you give him credit, chose to come in here and slug it out with Rahman. Give him credit on one.
Look at him here in this first round. Rahman kept the pressure on. He stayed in the face of Pinnell, made Pinnell work without getting tagged with any big shots from Steve, and then started clubbing his shots. And there is the right hand that put Pinnell down to the canvas. Pinnell even shaking his head no while he was staying on the canvas. Here's another look at that same knockdown. Look at the right hands from Rahman. He says that is his best punch. He is naturally right-handed. Also has a terrific left hook. A good combination from Haseem Rahman. That's why they call him the Rock. He has rocks in those fists.
I thought it was because of his name.
Oh, yeah, tell him that.
And a standing eight? No. Knocked down because Pinnell was saved by the ropes. Rahman came in with 12 knockouts in the first round, and right now that big right hand is rocking.
And Pinnell just a sitting duck for Haseem.
His left hand comes down, and Rahman has found the mark. And that just kind of getting out of the way of the propensity of punches. The knockdown rule is not in effect, but you get the idea. Johnny Femia watching very closely. One more could just about do it.
No.
Just buying time there is Pinnell. Crowd doesn't appreciate it, but for Pinnell, it just saved him some seconds and giving a chance to try to clear the cobwebs. But Rahman has been scoring with the right. It appears as if it's a matter of time. Matter of seconds, perhaps.
Matter of punches, missing the shots. Rahman getting a little bit excited. Now he goes back to the body. When you missed a head, go downstairs.
Let him go, son. Break. Step back.
Pinnell doing anything he can to stay in this fight. Just trying not to get hit, but there was a glancing blow to left hook.
And Johnny Femi is going to let Pinnell try to make it up.
Seven,
he didn't get hit.
8, 9, 10.
All right, takes the 10 count. Pinnell takes the 10 count and does his best job of acting, trying to say, number three rating. And Steve Pinnell does not even have anywhere near that number three rating.
We have a couple of more heavyweights coming up, but first let's get the official time into the ring. Here's Mark Biro. Biro.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time, 1:48 of the second round. The winner by knockout and still undefeated and still IBF Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Haseem The Rock.